Why is it important not to compare yourself with others? Today we're going to talk about self-esteem, self-confidence, and self-criticism, and of course, comparison. My name is Elena Semenek, and this is my YouTube channel, Psychology of Happiness. Welcome. I will try to explain to you in a very simple way so you can remember it once and for all that comparing yourself to others is not a good thing. Basically, when you compare yourself to other people, in 99% you will reach one of two decisions. You are better than others or you are worse than others. Let's look into both situations. So if you compare yourself to your friend, to your coworker, to your mother, to your sister, does not matter, and you decide that you are worse than the other person. So as a result, you feel bad, your self-esteem goes down, you devalue yourself, you feel that other people are not interested in you because you are not as good as them, so they probably don't want to hang out with you. When you are in a company with friends or with your relatives, you feel that they are doing you a favor being around you, and you feel basically that you are not you cannot take part of your circle. You feel like you are abandoned by the circle and you feel that something is wrong with you. So you cannot create deep relationship, you cannot open your heart, you cannot achieve your goals, of course, because you believe that you are not worthy, and you feel down and depressed. On the other hand, if you compare yourself to others and decide that you are better than the other person, then you kind of in the similar situation as the first one, but a little bit opposite. You think that you are smarter, so other people, they may be, stupid, they may be lazy, they may be not as successful as you are. You feel that maybe they're not as cool as you are, they are boring, and at the end you are still alone because you are only the only one who is as cool as you are, basically. At the end you're still lonely because you're here and they are, below you. So you can't really create equal relationships. You can't really create honest relationship, open relationship, because every time when you're gonna talk to your friend, you will feel like, she's stupid. Like she does not really know what she's talking about. Oh, like she's something is wrong with her. So, and you're gonna feel lonely because you are there and they are here, and there's a huge gap between you. And again, it's like you don't have people who support you, you don't have people who value you, and there is nobody that you can share your true feelings with. There is no real connection in your life, there is no real emotion that you can, share with another person. So that's why it does not make sense. It's nonsense to compare yourself to other people because every time you're gonna feel lonely, no matter if you're better or worse. And the only person that you should compare yourself with is yourself. You should compare yourself today with yourself yesterday, a year ago, 5 years ago. So for example, I can say about myself, like right now I weigh 125 pounds, but 2 years ago I was 135 pounds. Wow, I did such a good job. I feel good about myself. My self-confidence goes up, my self-esteem goes up, and I feel great. I feel great as a person. I feel great of who I am. So when you compare yourself with yourself, you can see the progress and you feel good about yourself. This way you can create loving, caring, supportive relationships with other people. Because you're not comparing yourself with the other person. You know that you know who you are, and you're not constantly thinking, am I smarter? Did I say something stupid? should I say something or should I, you know, keep my mouth shut? You are not dealing with all those things, rather that you creating a deep, honest relationships. When you don't need to compare yourself with others, you can live your life, you can feel your life, you can enjoy your life and people around you. So I encourage you to compare yourself only with yourself and try to be kind to yourself. Try to be accepting to yourself. Allow yourself to make mistakes. You are unique and we are human, we're not robots. And on this note, I would like to invite you to my private sessions. I would like to invite you to my group therapy. I have art therapy in a group. I have regular group therapy. I have support group for parents and grandparents. And I have online courses that you can do on your own. And of course, I have lots of free stuff, guided meditation, breathing exercises, just regular exercises. You can find everything on my website. And if you subscribe to my newsletter, I will send you 7 free self-development webinars, 7 free guided meditations, and 7 free psychological self-development, self-improvement exercises. All the links below the video description. And as usual, if you like my channel, please give me likes and write your questions, your thoughts, your comments below the video. If you agree with me, please let me know. If you disagree with me, please let me know. Let's create a conversation. When you write your comments, when you give me your likes, when you share my video with other people, it really, really helps my channel. And I am asking you to do it more and more, because this way we can, you know, create the giving and receiving relationship. I give you, you give me, and we can grow together. So I will see you next time. I'm looking forward to your questions. Let me know what topics do you want me to talk about, and I will be happy to create videos for you. Until the next time, bye.